It's good to have you join us on AD4TV Radio News Update, coming to you live from Abuja, Nigeria's federal capital. I am Merciful Ajinomo. The disbursement of the first tranche of Central Bank of Nigeria's 50 billion naira targeted credit facility will begin this Thursday. The fund is being managed by Nissal Microfinance Bank, whose managing director, Abubakar Kure, confirmed the disbursement in a telephone interview, adding that the fund has received over 80,000 applications. The CBN introduced the 50 billion naira targeted credit facility as a stimulus package to support households and micro, small and medium enterprises affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. The guidelines released by CBN list potential beneficiaries of the funds as households with evidence of livelihoods adversely impacted by COVID-19, existing enterprises with evidence of business activities adversely affected by the COVID-19 pandemic, and enterprises with bankable plans. In another development, Kaduna State Governor Nasir El-Rufai has recovered from coronavirus. El-Rufai, who said he tested negative twice for the virus, described his experience in isolation as a medical regime. The governor thanked his family members for being supportive while also commending the Kaduna health workers and his deputy, Hadiza Balarabe, who chairs the state's task force on COVID-19. Still on the pandemic, in Nigeria, the director of the Center for the Infectious Diseases Research of Aminu Kano Teaching Hospital, Isa Abubakar, on Wednesday said the newly established testing center for COVID-19 in Kano State has run out of test kits, as a result suspended its operation until new kits are supplied from Abuja. He said that samples taken in Kano will be sent to Abuja for testing, pending the resumption of operation at the Kano Testing Center, noting that the laboratory will be fumigated during the closure as part of routine biosafety measures. Meanwhile, the KB State government in Nigeria this Tuesday began the process of decongesting prisons in the state following approval by the governor, Abubakar Atiku Bagudu, in line with the federal government's decongestion policy to prevent inmates from contracting COVID-19. KB State Attorney General and Commissioner for Justice, Barrister Ramatu Auji, made this known during the release of 111 inmates at Arugungu and Benin KB new and old correctional service centers. She disclosed that the state government paid the fines of the inmates and gave them 10,000 naira each to cater for transportation to the destinations, while encouraging them to be of good character as they rejoin their communities. Speaking at the release, the state chief judge, Justice Suleiman Muhammad, said some of the inmates who regained their freedom received presidential pardons, while the remaining were either fully discharged or released on administrative bail. The Minister of Environment in Nigeria, Mahmoud Abubakar, during a media briefing of the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19 in Abuja on Tuesday, said the ministry, in collaboration with the Nigerian Civil Aviation Authority and the Federal Airport Authority of Nigeria, have mapped out 125 aircraft and 13 airports across the country for decontamination and disinfection. He said the ministry had started producing herbal-based hand sanitizers and begun distribution of the product to communities and security operatives, enforcing the lockdown directive. Mahmoud added that the ministry had deployed 7,000 environmental officers in the 774 local government areas of the Federation for awareness creation and advocacy on the virus. In another development, the National Information Technology Development Agency has warned Nigerians to be wary of a fake COVID-19 relief disbursement data collection form in circulation, describing it a fraud. The information form being circulated, which has now gone viral on various social media platforms, requests users to provide their personal data such as phone number, email address and bank details, among others. In its response, the agency cautions that the site is fraudulent and that governments at all levels have established official channels for collecting information for the purpose of disbursing palliatives. Coming up in the second part of this bulletin, Madagascar announces a homegrown medicine it says can cure coronavirus, and 88 policemen in South Africa arrested for flouting the country's lockdown order. We'll be right back shortly.
As the world faces the challenge of the coronavirus pandemic and governments around the world are racing against time, AD4TV Radio thanks you all for doing your part to stop the spread of the disease. Be safe at home and practice hygiene. Protect yourself and others. Do not panic. Do not self-medicate. Listen to all preventive advice and stay at home, as well as maintain social distancing. Say no to fake news. Get authentic updates from the Presidential Task Force on COVID-19, the Federal Ministry of Health, the NCDC, and of course, AD4 TV Radio, your credible and reliable channel. Please stay safe to save others.
Thanks for staying with AD4 TV Radio. And now to international news. Madagascan President Andry Rajoelina has officially launched a medicine he believes can prevent infection and cure patients suffering from COVID-19. Developed by the Malagasy Institute of Applied Research and branded COVID Organics, President Rajoelina presented a said remedy to the press on Monday. It contains Artemisia, a plant cultivated on the Big Island to treat malaria. The president said all trials and tests have been conducted and its efficacy in the elimination of COVID-19 symptoms has been proven in Madagascar. He added that the drug will be distributed free of charge to vulnerable citizens and sold at very low prices to others. And South Africa's police minister, Becky Sella, this Wednesday said scores of government officials, including 89 police officers, have been arrested for flouting the country's coronavirus regulations. The minister, while speaking to newsmen in Durban, said altogether 131 people, including officials, councillors, health officials, correctional services, have been arrested. Sellers said many of the officers were apprehended for selling liquor they had confiscated from members of the public. And the Iranian Revolutionary Guards Corps on Wednesday said it had successfully launched the country's first military satellite into orbit at a time of heightened tensions with the United States over Tehran's nuclear and missile programs. United States official fair long-range ballistic technology used to put satellites into orbit could also be used to launch nuclear warheads. Tehran, however, denies allegations that such activity is a cover for ballistic missile development and insists it has never pursued the development of nuclear weapons. In a related development, United States President Donald Trump this Wednesday said he had instructed the United States Navy to fire at any Iranian ships that harass it at sea. This comes a week after vessels from Iran's Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps Navy came dangerously close to U.S. ships in the Gulf. Trump made a statement on Twitter hours after Iran said it had launched the country's first military satellite into orbit. Now, residents of Los Angeles, United States, experienced a 3.6 magnitude earthquake in the Granada Hills area in Southern California. According to the U.S. Geological Survey, the quake hit shortly after 11:40 p.m. and hit nearly 2 miles northeast from Granada Hills on Tuesday night with a depth of about 4 miles with no major damage. The Los Angeles police confirmed the earthquake, stating that so far there have been no reports of damage or injuries to the Los Angeles Police Department. Los Angeles Mayor Eric Garcetti said the LA Fire Department had been activated to conduct its routine survey of the city to assess for any damage. That's it on AD4 TV Radio News Update, coming to you live from Abuja, Nigeria's capital. You can join the conversation on our social media platforms at AD4 TV Radio on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and Instagram. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel at AD4 TV Radio. Many thanks for watching. I am Merciful Ajinomo.